Nobody plays guitar like this guy.
Hey, are you ready to learn how to put wow factor into Van Morrison song Moondance? Oh my gosh, this is a great song. Hey, it's not for the squeamish. Hey, but it is for some beginners, though. It's not too difficult to play. Couple of challenging chords, but I think you can get through with it. I'm going to show you how to play it and really put some wow factor into it. If you're a beginner, I'll show you how to strum it and make it really sound cool. And I'll even give you some chord changes that are a little bit easier for you to do. Don't back away from this one. You're going to love it. Here I go talking too much again. I know what you want to do. You want to learn it, and I want to teach it. So get your pick, get your guitar, and meet me back in the studio. I'm going to show you how to play Van Morrison's Moondance. Okay, let me show you the chords that you're going to play now. Throughout the whole song on the verses, there's only four chords that you play. Predominantly, this song has like six chords in it. And for the verses, you're just playing, you're just repeating four chords over and over again. So let me show you those four chords first. And then when we do the bridge, there's two chords in there that you play. So let me show you what we've got. You start off with an A minor. And I'm doing that A minor, just a basic A minor. And I'll put the chord diagrams up there for you too. I'm going to take my index finger, first fret on second, my ring finger, second fret on third, and my middle finger, second fret on four. And I'm playing open 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Then you have what they call a B minor 9. Now that sounds like a hard chord. It's nothing. All you do is move that A minor up two frets. Everything's the same. Move it up two frets. Now you can play it just the same as you do in A minor, same fingering. I'll change it and I'll just use my middle finger to pick up that third fret on the second string, my pinky fourth fret on three, and my ring finger fourth fret on four. But you can do it either way. Whatever's easiest for you. Okay, the other chords, you've got an A minor 7, and an A minor 7, all you're doing is you take that A minor and you take your middle finger off. So all you've got are these two strings, second fret on 4 and first fret on 2. Open third string. Kind of looks like that finger's touching something, but it's not. Look at your chord diagram. And then you also have a B minor 7, so you're raising that up 2. But you can't just play those like that because you got to pick up these a couple of more notes. So really the easiest thing that you can do there is if you're a very beginner, all you need to do is play a B minor like that. And what you're going to do is take your middle finger or your index finger, put it on the second fret of the first string, take your middle finger, third fret on 2, pinky, fourth fret on 3, and ring finger, fourth fret on 4. And you can get by doing that. It's not really the same sound, but if you're a beginner, you'll be fine just doing it that way, no problem. So you've got an A minor, a B minor 11, an A minor 7, and a B minor 7. And if you play chords well, you're going to want to play that B minor 7. If you're not a beginner, you want to play it with a bar chord. Those are the four chords that just keep repeating. Now let me show you something that will be fun for you to do, whether you're a beginner or advanced. When you play that A7, take your pinky and put it on the first fret, third string. Because when you go down and play that next B7, you get a little bit of a sound right there. That's how you get that wow factor. Those little sounds like that make a big difference. So when you put all four of those chords together, you've got... like that. Okay? Now, one other thing that you can do when you're playing that, if you're a beginner, don't worry about it. Just play those chords. If you're an advanced player and you're trying to put some wow factor into it, what you're going to want to do is a pull off on that fifth string with the third fret, second fret, and open. And you do it real fast. Just like that. And you do it right after you hit that B chord each time. So it'd be like this. Now that that's going to take some practice. I'm sitting here trying to think, am I hitting the right chord for these guys? And it throws me off. So you got to just get into it. Practice that. That'd be a great practice for you to start playing Wow Factor. That's a real cool little lick there if you can do that. Okay, so now let me show you how we're going to put those four chords together to get the intro and the first two verses. You play those chords 10 times. You play them twice for the intro and four times. You repeat them four times for the first two verses. So you've got two times for the intro, four times for the first verse, four times for the second verse. Okay, so 10 times you're going to repeat that. So let me show you how that's going to go. I'll try and do some words for this, but it's hard for me to sing it. I don't know the words to the song, so I'm trying to look at the words and the chords and all that at the same time and trying to throw those riffs in there for you. So hopefully I'll probably just going to play it for you because I just don't know the words good enough to play and sing it. So here we go. One, two, three, four. It's a marvelous night for a moon dance, with the stars up above in your eyes. A fantabulous night to make romance, with the color of October skies. All the leaves on the trees are a-falling, and the sounds and the breezes that blow. And I'm trying to place all the calling to the heartstrings that play soft and low. Okay, now I threw the wrong chord in. That's supposed to be a B7, but I'm trying to look at these words at the same time and show you how that goes. So you're just going to keep repeating those chords. Okay, so now the next, now you got a bridge. That bridge goes like this, and this is really going to be a cool thing for you to play. I'm going to show you some really cool little Wow Factor riffs in here for this one. You know that, and it goes, you know the night's magic seems to whisper and touch. So what you've got here, you've got a D minor 7, and that D minor 7, all you're doing there is take your index finger, put it on the first fret of the first and second string, and your middle finger picks up the second fret of the third string, and you play that open 4. You got that A minor 7 again, right? Now, one thing that you can do when you hit that A minor 7, you can take that pinky now, because your pinky's freed up, and throw it on that second fret, second string, third fret, like that. If you want to do that, I'm going to show you another little riff that you can do. Okay, and here's what he's saying there. Let me show you how this goes. You put these just two chords together, go like that. You know the night's magic seems to whisper and touch. You know the soft light seems to shine in your blush. Okay, now, most guys will show you that you're just going to play that I threw an E7 chord in there at the end. You'll see that seems to shine in your blush. Most guys are going to show you to play that E7 three times. I'm going to tell you something. If you want to put some Wow Factor into this song, you play it twice and then hit an E chord. And if you listen to that song, you'll hear it in there. So it goes like this. Seems to shine to in your blush. Like that. So let's try that again. Just that bridge. One, two, three, four. You know the night's magic. In your blush, like that. Now, if you can put some Wow Factor into this, let me show you what you can do here. The easiest thing to do when you come down to that first D minor 7, instead of playing it with that middle finger on that second fret of the third string, use your ring finger and pick that chord, that note up. Okay? So you're still playing that. Now take that ring finger and get it on that second fret. You know the note. As magic seems to whisper and hush. Now the soft moonlight seems to shine in your blush. Just like that. Into this, here's a real cool little riff that you can put in there. When you hit that A minor,